Okay, from the sun back to Paris, more ground to earth. I guess you were all super excited today to wake up in the morning and come to this special day. And I guess you dressed up, you took your bag, and then you took the stairs, and you found your way to AXA headquarters. 50 years from now, it will not be that easy for you even to take the bag and going down the stairs. It's going to be quite a challenge. And even worse, there's a good chance in 50 years you're not going to remember any of these experiences coming every day to AXA. You're not going even to remember you worked for AXA or even lived in Paris. And I know it sounds a bit sad, but this gradual loss of one's personality is what gives me the motivation to do my research. My name is Shahaf Peleg, and I'm working on aging and how to live healthier and longer. So I'm going to start with this very simple concept. You have here orchestra, which you can think about it as the DNA. And the DNA is composed from many genes, which you can associate with different musicians. And it's all very nice, but alone, they cannot do anything. They need a conductor to really orchestrate the orchestra to make this music in tune, right? And we know now, in aging, the conductor starts making mistakes, which is very bad for us. And how do we think it happens? So we know, for instance, in young animals, and I'm going to talk, I forgot to mention, I'm going to talk about flies as model, this little zzz thingy. And then we have in young energy production in the cells, and we have on the other end the gene orchestration. And the uniqueness of my project is try to bring these two subfields together. And what I found out that there is a messenger, or there are messages going from the energy production to the gene orchestration. And in young, don't worry, everything is fine. The problem is as we reach midlife, something around 40 or 45, the energy production starts to change. It actually starts to increase for unknown reason. And as a byproduct, the message or the messenger is becoming stronger, which is bad because it makes the genes go out of tune. It affects the conductor. And that in turn creates cellular damage and also memory impairment. Unfortunately for my talk, I cannot focus on this. You can come to me later and talk about it. I'm going to talk about just physical damage. I'm going to illustrate it in these two movies. You see on the left, there are young flies, and here they are midlife flies. We knock them down, and we measure how much time and how high the flies can go up. And you can see the young flies really get the task very easy. They go up quite high. The midlife are really lazy. They stay really down. The main point, can we help the mid-fly? Are we going to give up or are we going to try to do something? And the idea that I had was to actually, it's very difficult to target the energy production or the orchestration, but we can target the messenger. So we can, genetically or with drugs, that's what we are testing, we can try to reduce the effect of the messenger. And now if you compare flies at the same age at midlife, these are normal flies, and these are flies where we reduce the messenger, you can see that the physical activity is increased. And if you bring it to the AXA world, you can say, these two flies pay the same money to AXA, they are the same age, but these ones are probably going to use the AXA insurance much more often. hopefully, it is my hope now to move a bit forward and try to translate this knowledge that we acquired from the flies, design drug targets so we can translate it for us human, and hopefully in the future it can help us at least to solve some of the age-related problems. And I just would like to acknowledge everyone and also our two wonderful coaches. It was great 2 days. I did great, right? Okay. And thank you very much for your attention.